Salamid, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. How are you doing?
Fine. I'm calling you, Salamid, because in the 80s and 90s you were covering the war between Israel and Hezbollah in Lebanon for a TV network in Lebanon and in the Middle East. Now, after this attack or assassination in Damascus against Imad Mouraniye, what do you think? What will be the reaction of Hezbollah concerning this assassination?
I believe from the minute that Hezbollah knew about the killing of Mouraniye, Hezbollah took the decision to retaliate. And in my opinion, Hezbollah will be looking to target key people in the Israeli government or key people in the Israeli Defense Army.
When you said that you believe that Hezbollah will try to kill key people in the Israeli army or in the political establishment, what are you based on in order to tell such a thing?
You know, as someone who followed and covered the war between Israel and Hezbollah, through the years we knew the way that Hezbollah will use to retaliate. I wouldn't expect Hezbollah to be looking for somebody else to retaliate. They will do whatever it takes to take out or kill anyone that they can reach outside Israel. Hezbollah is coordinating with Syria and Iran, no doubt about it. But when they will decide to do their special operations, I believe they will do it with the Iranians only. And if they will be capable of carry on a unique operation in their perspective, I mean, unique operation will mean that they will be able to target a key person in the Israeli intelligence or a key person from the Ministry of Defense. And I could tell you, Imad Mouraniye for Hezbollah is like Yehud Barak for Israel.
You know very well Hezbollah methods and tactics. Can you tell us who is able to replace today, on a military point of view, Imad Mouraniye?
I'm not in a position to be able to tell who will replace him. But in my opinion, after his long years with Hezbollah, he's not replaceable.
You are following the event from Lebanon. Have you talked with people in Beirut, in Lebanon, since the assassination?
As a journalist, I'm in daily contact with people in Beirut and in the Middle East, and I could tell you the situation is not a pleasant situation, and nobody can predict what will happen. But as we have seen recently, the flame started between the Shia and the Sunni, and I don't know if anybody can stop this, but we have to wait and see.
Do you believe that Hezbollah is able to launch a war against Israel as a retaliation, or you think it will be only a terrorist attack on a larger scale?
I would believe that Israel is not, I believe Hezbollah will not wage a war against Israel just for the killing of Mouraniye. They will try to retaliate like one-on-one. I mean, Israel killed one in their opinion, and they will be looking for the right one to just take revenge.
What is today the atmosphere in the Dahiya neighborhood of Beirut? Because you talk with people in Beirut the last days. What do they feel? What is the general atmosphere there?
I do believe that Hezbollah is facing pressure from Israel and from the U.S., and Hezbollah is facing internal pressure in Lebanon. So the situation of Hezbollah is not a perfect situation, but we should not underestimate the power of Hezbollah in Lebanon. Hezbollah is still very active and very strong in Lebanon.
Now, on a political point of view, Lebanon is still struggling in order to get a president. This situation now is, of course, worsening the situation. What do you see as a Lebanese political state right now?
You know, Hezbollah has a lot of influence in Lebanon. And the people of Hariri and Jumblat and others are trying to win the political power in Lebanon. But in the time being, I could say no one has power enough to take over. Unfortunately, Hezbollah is well established comparing to the others, and I'm afraid that the day will come if the confrontation will take place, it will be another civil war between the Lebanese, and the Lebanese will kill each other, and it will be a chaos. It will not be good for anybody.
Salamid, the last question. After Imad Mourani's assassination, do you believe that maybe people like Walid Jumblat are interested to go on and to maybe to try to assassinate Nasrallah in order to break down totally the Hezbollah movement?
No, I don't think so. I believe Walid Jumblat is a lot smarter, and he wouldn't be doing something like that. But as I told you, sure enough, Hezbollah is facing internal pressure, mainly from Walid Jumblat and his supporters. But I'm not sure if they will reach the point to face each other on the main street.
If you were an Israeli, what would you do now?
You know, first I'm a Lebanese, and I wish all the best for Israel and the Jewish nation, but all what I can tell you, Israel should be ready for a severe retaliation if it will happen tomorrow or 1 year from now. After years of covering those people, I could tell you if they need to do something to take revenge, they will wait and wait until they will make it happen. So the Israelis should not forget about it in 3 months from now and enjoy their life in a normal way, and then the retaliation will reach them.
Salamid, thank you very much. I remind that you are a journalist now working in America, and you were covering for almost 15 years the war between Israel and Hezbollah in Lebanon. Thank you very much, Salam.
Thank you.